Welcome back to the special coverage of the Bengaluru Roadshow of Uttar Pradesh Investors Summit 2018. The Uttar Pradesh government has designed an industrial investment and employment promotion policy to establish the state as a competitive investment destination, generate employment, and ignite sustainable, inclusive, and balanced economic growth. Uttar Pradesh has abundant skilled manpower, formed simple and transparent single window clearance systems to set up industries, is developing smart cities, and steps are taken to ease the doing of business. To highlight more on this, Satish Mahana, Minister of Industrial Development, Government of Uttar Pradesh, addressed the forum.
On behalf of Government of Uttar Pradesh, I welcome you all to this exclusive curtain raiser for Uttar Pradesh Investment Summit 2018. The state is poised to become one of the favorite business destinations of the country. The recently introduced Industrial Investment and Employment Policy of the state government is a reflection and roadmap for the holistic approach that the administration has adopted towards not only industrial development, but also improving the overall standard of living, creation of jobs, improvement in law and order situation, and exploring new avenues for sustainable policy framework. With a population 220 million, we are not only the most populous state in India, but the largest talent pool of skilled and semi-skilled manpower. The last revelation of the day is about the simplicity and transparency of our single window clearance mechanism. It is a web-based single table system for the entrepreneurs who are willing to invest and set up industries in the state. In a span of few months, we have taken landmark initiatives like the sanctioning of Jewar Airport, Purvanchal Express Highway, Bundelkhand Express Highway. These initiatives, along with the DMIC and AKIC, will completely revolutionize the economic and industrial scenario in the state. We are also coming up with smart cities along with AKIC corridor, which will be a smart mixed industries and residential hubs. We are already ready to give a red carpet welcome to industries across the country. Come, let us strive together to go together. Truly, UP stands for ease of business, and the government is ensuring that every step a business finds a reason and medium to grow, complete and flourish. When you do business in UP, you will find U stands for upgrade and P for progress. It's not only business. I would like to conclude by welcoming you all to explore the diversity of our state has offered. Besides being famous from Kumbh Mela, the Varanasi Ghats, the most definitely Taj Mahal, Uttar Pradesh boasts one of the oldest cultures and is home of historical cities like Varanasi, Kaushambi, Saraswati, Kushinagar, Agra, Lucknow, Chitrakoot, etc. The image what Uttar Pradesh had for the last many years, that is changing very rapidly. Before that, law and order, this was the main problem, what people thought across the country, that Uttar Pradesh is not having a good law and order position. But now, when our Chief Minister, Shri Yogi Adityanath, has taken over as a Chief Minister, his first priority was to control law and order position. He said that we have zero tolerance against the people, those who are criminals and those who are protecting the criminals also. When I say when we are in Bangalore, then my colleagues also, my officers also, they also said that Bangalore is being saturated as far as IT is concerned. Now, when you have to find some other destination, that is the Uttar Pradesh. I am here to welcome you all for 21st and 22nd of February for an investment summit which we are going to have there in Lucknow. Thank you very much.
Both speaking on the investment opportunities in the state of Uttar Pradesh, the floor was opened for a Q&A round between the members of the panel and the investors present at the summit.
So my question is to Honorable Minister, is there any special incentive for such kind of people, those who have already done some 25 years of great work in the industry, and they want to set up something over there. I want to do something in Lucknow or eastern part of the UP. So is there any special incentive which you have thought over to bring in such kind of people back to the, you know, state?
As far as this eastern part of this Uttar Pradesh is concerned, so we have come up with the very special incentives for Purvanchal and Bundelkhand also. We are going back to reimburse 300% of the capital investment what you have invested by refunding you the share of the GST, that means SGST, up to 300% for the 50, that limit will be up to 15 years now. So we have other incentives also, because we want to promote industries in these areas, because these are very backward areas as far as industries is concerned.
We have a graded system, 100% in Paschimanchal, 80% in Noida, and 200% in Madhyanchal, which is Kanpur, and 300% in Bundelkhand and Purvanchal.
What UP is offering us different from what Jaipur or Indore is offering? Why should we come to Lucknow or a place like Kanpur, where there is always a threat to security of the establishment, and then not going to Indore or Jaipur, which are again those tier 2 cities which offer a similar kind of infrastructure and a demographic? Thank you.
Promise you that we are there to for security purposes are concerned, we are there to protect you. And now that UP has changed now, as I told you, the priority of our government for the first at the first meeting only, our Honorable Chief Minister said that apradhiyon ke liye koi sthan nahi hai. We have zero tolerance. And as I told you, not only these people, those are creating nuisance, they will also be sent behind the bars, and the people protecting them also, they will also be sent. They will make it sure that they must be in those places where they deserve to be, and they will be behind the bars now.
My question to you, sir, is about the inclusive growth, you know. I mean, talk about the big projects, you know, that will be limited, you know. UP being such a massive place, you know, we have to talk about the inclusive growth. So I just wanted to know, Pandeji, and some highlight from the Honorable Minister as what are you doing about that, so that, you know, people like us who are there, you know, can come to UP and start in a smaller way.
This government has come with a purpose, and three things which we are doing. One, which I mentioned in my presentation. One, in infrastructure, you saw the kind of roads that we're building, the kind of infrastructure things that we're building. Two, the governance initiative. And third, the law and order. If these three elements are put in place, you will see UP will become a chaman.
At the close of the Bangalore Roadshow of the UP Investor Summit 2018, the investors had a clearer idea of the benefits of investing in Uttar Pradesh.
UP is emerging in a very fast way. The government is quite stable, and there's a lot of things happening over there. It's a pretty large state, and a lot of consumers as well. The consumption of electricity is also going to be very high. So once there's a lot of production which will happen, which they want to at least, I think there are a lot of scope for many different companies to start their business over there. And that's what we see.
The ease of doing business has improved tremendously. Law and order situation is absolutely changed from what it is perceived to be. And we have put in place a very, very practicable policy on labor. The incentives are there, the new IT policy is there. So all are welcome. We welcome you with open arms.
One thing I liked was inclusiveness. So they are trying to not focus just on one city or one sector. So it's not just Lucknow or Noida. So if you go to Eastern UP, you have more benefits from the government. So they are trying to very, very clearly develop the backward regions as well. So that was one very good inclusive approach. That is something I liked. The second thing was promising security to industry. And saying there's zero tolerance to crime and zero tolerance to law and order mischief, you know. So I think that was something very, very good. These two things will give tremendous confidence to industry.
I was very inspired today listening to the entire government, including the Minister for Industrial Development there. talking about very critical things, not just financial benefits, but also talking about security, about zero tolerance to stuff that is criminally offensive and so on and so forth. So keeping that, I would really certainly explore, this possibility now.
Partnered by Times Influence.
Welcome back to the special coverage of the Bengaluru Roadshow of Uttar Pradesh Investors Summit 2018. The Indian IT industry has led the economic transformation of the country, and Uttar Pradesh has emerged as a hub of IT and ITES and electronics manufacturing sector. With the increasing upgradations in the infrastructure, massive subscriber base, plethora of policy initiatives, and the construction of new IT parks, Uttar Pradesh has become the best investment destination in the IT sector. To put the spotlight on this, Sanjeev Saran, Additional Chief Secretary, IT and Electronics, Government of Uttar Pradesh, addressed the forum.
Noida, Greater Noida, and Yamuna Expressway are today have emerged as a major hub of the IT sector as also the electronic manufacturing sector. The location of UP, especially the new electronic manufacturing zone that has been declared, which includes Noida, Greater Noida, and Yamuna Expressway. The main advantage is the geographical location. We are at the junction of the Eastern Dedicated Freight Corridor or the Amritsar-Kolkata Industrial Corridor and the Delhi-Mumbai Industrial Corridor. So anyone who is desirous of exporting from UP or anyone who wants to get their raw materials from the ports, for them, this is the best destination. As far as the IT sector is concerned, so far the development was taking place in Noida and Greater Noida, and Noida itself has about 2,000 startups. So it's become a major hub for software development and for other and for startups in other areas. But we are now spreading the IT movement throughout the state. So we are setting up an IT park in Agra, one in Meerut, Gorakhpur, Varanasi, Bareilly, Kanpur. There is already one park running in Lucknow. Now, under the IT policy, we are providing the fiscal incentives. Again, the rebate on land is there. Then on case-to-case basis, all the projects which are more than 200 crores on the initial cost, then we provide some additional incentives. As far as the startup movement is concerned, we are developing a large startup ecosystem. The state is setting up a 1,000 crore startup fund, which will be operated by SIDBI. And for the incubators, we have a special scheme where we provide 25 lakh rupees support, and it is not only to government institutions, but institutions, even the private education institutions. Then we are providing mentorship assistance, that is to enable the incubators to obtain mentors and to provide for their airfare and things like that. Then we are also providing monthly sustenance allowance for the startup, for the entrepreneurs, because they need something really to pull them through their struggle phase. Bangalore is the capital of IT industry in the country, and most of the industries are now expanding to cover all states, whether it is in the IT sector or for data centers. So I'd like to welcome all of you to UP, and all of you are welcome to Global Investor Summit on the 21st and 22nd of February in Lucknow. Thank you.
We have our new industrial policy in place, new startup policy, new IT policy. The whole plethora is there. And in addition to this, the single window system is being monitored on a very, very rigorous basis. We want that the investors should feel a clear difference in the way they are being treated in the state. It's not as if they are running from pillar to post for small things.
UP is vast and we have huge land banks available, and I said the manpower availability. Power is no more a problem. We have huge, abundant supply of power. And there's a huge amount of enthusiasm amongst the investors, the community as a whole who wants to come and start businesses in Uttar Pradesh.
Partnered by Times Influence.
Hello and welcome to the special coverage on the domestic roadshow of the Uttar Pradesh Investors Summit 2018. To showcase the investment opportunities and potential in the various sectors of Uttar Pradesh, the UP government had organized roadshows in cities across India. In the financial capital of the country, Mumbai, the roadshow received an overwhelming response from the domestic as well as foreign investors. The Chief Minister of Uttar Pradesh, Yogi Adityanath, had addressed the gathering.
उद्योग जगत के हमारे जितने भी यहाँ पर महानुभाव उपस्थित हैं, मैं उन सब को उत्तर प्रदेश का उत्कृष्ट निवेश गंतव्य बनाने के लिए जब उत्तर प्रदेश तैयार है तो मैं आप सबको इसके लिए सादर आमंत्रित करता हूँ और विश्वास व्यक्त करता हूँ कि 21-22 फरवरी को उत्तर प्रदेश की राजधानी लखनऊ में आयोजित होने वाले यूपी इन्वेस्टर समिट में आप सब पधार करके उत्तर प्रदेश की उन संभावनाओं के साथ अपने आप को जोड़ करके उत्तर प्रदेश के विकास में अपना योगदान देंगे.
To shed more light on investment opportunities, the Chief Minister of Uttar Pradesh, Yogi Adityanath, met a galaxy of industrialists in Mumbai. In Bengaluru, the IT capital of India, the roadshow called all the investors towards the state with the new IT policies and also showcased the new infrastructure development in the state to attract investors.
Ladies and gentlemen, the government of Uttar Pradesh has started this very sustained campaign to showcase what Uttar Pradesh can offer to them. Uttar Pradesh is an extremely resource-rich state and it has a lot of scope for industrial development through investments in various sectors and thus contribute to the development of the state as well as nation's economy. You would agree, if India has to grow in double digits or at 8% plus, the largest and the most populous state of this country, Uttar Pradesh, has to grow at least 10 to 12 percentage points. Then Uttar Pradesh will become the epicenter and the prime mover of India's growth. The participation of so many of you business leaders from South Zone at this interaction today signifies the interest of entrepreneurs in the emerging and new emerging capital, industrial capital, Uttar Pradesh.
Investing in Uttar Pradesh has many advantages of its own, which include locational advantage, excellent connectivity, industrial corridors, utilities like 24/7 availability of water and electricity, skilled manpower and proactive governance. To talk more about the advantages, Anoop Chandra Pandey, Infrastructure and Industrial Development Commissioner, Government of Uttar Pradesh, addressed the forum.
I am giving you a snapshot of why should we invest in Uttar Pradesh? We have the locational advantage. We have access to 200 million population, which is the highest market in India. If you see globally, if UP would be a separate country, it would be the sixth largest global market in the world. So that is the access to population. It has access to the NCR on the west and strategic access to market and resource depth of eastern India. When we talk of connectivity, so I would tell you that connectivity has increased a lot over years, and to top it up, we are coming out with Jewar Airport. We are building this airport three times the size of Delhi Airport. The connectivity, we are having this freight corridor So this freight corridor from DMIC, the Dadri Mumbai freight corridor, the western corridor, and AKID, the Amritsar Calcutta freight corridor. 15% of this western corridor lies in UP, and 57% of this eastern corridor lies in UP. So Dadri, which is the place of junction of both these corridors, would emerge as probably the logistic hub capital of India, catering to the entire North India. Now there is no need of maintaining separate warehouses in different states. So we are coming out with our logistics policy, and we aim that this logistic hub would cater to the entire North India. We have abundant land parcels. I have already asked all my authorities to earmark specific land parcels, and we are coming out with a huge pharma park in the vicinity of Delhi at Noida, Greater Noida. We are coming out with logistic park. We are coming out with food parks, with leather park, with all kinds of parks. We have earmarked specific places for them where we would ensure all kinds of facilities at one place. I invite the industry from Bangalore, from this particular area. You come over, invest in UP, you write to me email, we would immediately respond, give you specific land parcels with total availability of water, 24/7 reliable electricity with provision of open access. Before coming here, we have already issued our new industrial policy, which today, I can vouch for it, is the best industrial policy in the country. To top it up, before coming to Bangalore, we ensured last week that we have our IT policy, startup policy, electronic manufacturing policy in place.
Uttar Pradesh has a very large population of more than 21 crores. So it is a very big market for everything, from consumer goods as well as industrial goods. So with the new GST in place, UP is very preferred destination for investments. And with the new government into power, a lot of new policies, new incentives have been announced. There is a very good climate for the new investments.